In this video, we're going to take a quick tour of RIP-Queue, which is essentially your dashboard. We'll start at the top in the toolbar. There are icons in the toolbar that make navigating RIP-Queue easy and quick. You can move to other tools and features right from this home screen. You can edit jobs, configure a printer, launch Media Manager for color profiling, or access swatch books. Just below the toolbar, we see active printers. Columns include details about the printer's configuration. We can see media type, roll size, placement strategy. The selected printer will filter the user interface. This will refresh and display the active or buffered job list as well as the print preview on the far right side. We also have an option to show all jobs for the selected printer or for all printers. In the next section below, we see jobs ready to print, displaying our active jobs. This shows us what jobs we have in our queue. You can customize the job listing by right-clicking in the column heading. You can change your preview size or enable or disable any of these options to appear or disappear in the columns across. The buttons on the left can change your order in the queue or allow you to delete jobs or put a job on hold, which will temporarily remove that job from the print preview print queue. Directly below the active jobs, we see our buffered jobs. These are jobs that have been printed. These jobs can be deleted or moved back up into the RIP queue to be reinstated and printed again. The buffered jobs area can also be customized for different preview size as well as options in the columns. We can also double-click on a job to open up the job properties. This allows us to see a larger preview as well as make some specific changes to the job. Sizing, rotation, number of copies, media type. On the right side of our RIP-Queue, we see the printer status, media, and placement strategy. When you select a specific printer in the active printer list, you can check the status, pause or start the printer by selecting this green circle to go offline. Turns that to a red circle. Then we can put that back online by clicking it again. This is where we can also change the media type that's currently loaded on the printer, or change our roll size or create a custom or temporary size of media. The placement drop-down menu allows you to change the way active jobs are grouped. We can also change our placement and nesting strategies in the General and Options tab. This allows us to control offsets, justification, space between copies, and how our files are going to fit on our media. Our print preview is going to give us a view of the nest based on our placement strategy option. In some cases, the placement strategy will require the operator to manually perform a print action by clicking on the Print Now button. This can be automated by selecting print jobs individually and having the trigger set to automatically print. Directly below our print preview, we see our console window. This will show us information as our files are being ripped. So there you have it, exploring the RIP-Queue dashboard. For more information, documentation, and videos, please visit our website at onyxgfx.com.